And the, you know, I'll give you an example, the $100,000 that we have earmarked for unbudgeted restaurant equipment. I don't think any of this equipment has been touched since the day this place was built. You know, it's unfortunate that we have to bring things before you guys, but we either have to choose to fix them and try to work with it, or continue to ignore it and push it off, and it's only going to get worse. I mean, some of this stuff is in really, really bad shape. Jeff, what year was the golf course built?
'95, opened in '95, built in '94.
I mean, refrigeration equipment, that's 1995, it's, you know, it's still held together with tape, and it's just, it's ineffective, it's inefficient, it's problematic. We didn't build it, I didn't build it, but we have to deal with it. So I get that, you know, that these conversations are sometimes not fun, and certainly like the challenge of trying to do more with less. But there are some times, in this particular case, Councilman Johnson, I mean, we've heard it from Tifa time and time again about not coming back to them. So we elected to bring this budget amendment forward to city council as part of a general fund amendment in lieu of going back to Tifa for the request. But in terms of operations, I don't think we would do these things today, we would make these same decisions today if we were making them that they did 20 and 30 years ago. I mean, I don't think there's a market for a $26 million sportsplex today. But we have it, we don't get to undecide that, it's here, and we gotta figure it out.
Councilwoman Croft?
I have a question, just going forward, you know, given that you're updating a lot now, are you going to put together like a preventative maintenance or a life cycle type schedule to start swapping out this equipment, say, in 10, you know, as necessary?
Yeah, we talked about a capital improvement plan, and creating life expectancies for all this stuff, so everybody can see what's coming and when to expect things.
Right, okay.
Councilman Woolley?
I was just curious, I thought the flood might have took all that stuff out, too. Just thought, I wasn't sure.
Unfortunately, that was the only area that wasn't made of touch.
Mr. Kircher?
Yes, through chair, so just going forward, the Act 178 rubbish fund, there's only one small change in there, that's for the animal shelter at $15,000.
Right.
Which, like I said, that was part of that settlement that we wanted to put in there, it wasn't budgeted in our current budget, so we put that in there. So that's the only change in that fund. The police forfeiture fund for treasury, the only thing going on there is, the other revenue is your insurance proceeds for some of the vehicles that were damaged, and then the opposite would be the expense for the replacement and repairs of those vehicles. But we had to address it, so, because it wasn't in the budget, so we had to address it, so that's what those items were. And then finalizing on the golf course fund, we discussed the transfer in of the $400,000. And then the rest of the revenue changes are just related to the insurance proceeds for the flood at Lisa Taylor. And then on the expenditure side, you have that $200,000 increase to Taylor Meadows, which is the car barn expense that occurred. It wasn't in the current budget, because it was from the prior year, so it's a rollover of that budget. And then the Lisa Taylor amount of $754, which is the insurance expenditures related to the insurance proceeds, so.
Okay, is there any other questions for Mr. Kircher on this item? All right, thank you. Moving on to item 15, is there a motion to, motion to approve fiscal year 2018-2019 city fee schedule effective July 1, 2018. Mr. Kircher?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, just like every year, we become city council for approval of the fee schedule that encompasses all the departments. Budget and finance puts the numbers together, but we inquire all departments if there's any changes, what those changes are. So, well, changes are usually highlighted for the council members to easily gather that information. So if the council has any questions, any of the changes, or any fees, be happy to entertain those.
Councilman Johnson?
I just have one on the new assembly deposit, our fees, back call, $1,100 increase. I know you have vacation, but.
Which page is that, Councilman?
That's on the.
26.
Yeah.
I think that's, we don't have to test devices, is that what that is?
Is it under billing, is that where it's at?
It says meter assembly deposit.
Mr. Kircher?
For meter, for hydrants?
Actually, sorry.
I know what that is.
If I may, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, sorry, if I may.
Mr. Kircher?
With water billing, sorry, with water billing, we're making changes, so I'm kind of supervising water billing. And that change actually came out of the water billing my office. And what it is actually reflects actual cost. We actually looked at the actual cost for the meters, the backflows, and we added 25% to come up with what that cost should be. And it hasn't changed for years, but since we know what the actual costs are, we have the documents. That's why we increased it to what the actual cost is nowadays, plus the 25% markup.
Is there additional questions from council on the fee schedule? All right, thank you. Item 17 is a motion to approve the July 2018 payroll. All right. 18 is a motion to approve the acceptance of the 2016 home grant in the amount of $184,475 and authorize the mayor to sign the contract on behalf of the city of Taylor. Mr. Baum.
Thanks, Chairman. That's just a couple years behind, but we just got the contract from Wayne County, and we use that primarily now for down payment assistance
right.
and other things.
Okay. Is there any questions from council on this item? All right. Item 19, the motion to approve the acceptance of the 2017 home grant in the amount of $176,875 and authorize the mayor to sign the contract on behalf of the city of Taylor. Mr. Baum.
Ditto. that's for 2017. Then we also got news 2018 will be getting about a $60,000 increase. I think 2018 will be $247,000. So hopefully we can lure some new home buyers to Taylor, and then we'll be looking at other ways to use those funds.
Excellent. Any questions for Mr. Baum on this item? Okay. Item 20 is a motion to approve the payment in the amount of $17,550 to National Faith Home Buyers for the down payment assistance, home buyer number 2018-09 through 11, funded through home grants. Mr. Baum.
Thanks, Chairman. Again, that's the down payment assistance, which we primarily now, since we're out of Pinewood almost, to use the home grant for. See, we've already done 11. Last year we did 20, so it's a very popular program.
Any questions for Mr. Baum on this item? All right, thank you. Motion to approve solar illuminations, low quote, in the amount of $52,800 for the purchase of 60 solar LED park lamps and posts for city parks, funded through the Community Development Borac Grant and TBA Capital Outlay Accounts. Mr. Baum.
Thanks, Chairman. This is also Mr. Douglas as well. So 25 of these will be for parks that are located in Community Development Block Grant eligible areas. The other 35 will be funded through the Capital Building Outlay Fund. So it'll be 35 of those will go through that fund. And Guido's doing a study, and we'll forward it to you, but these are for safety features. There'll be solar lights at all our city parks that'll help with safety and illuminate them kind of to prevent loitering and that kind of stuff.
Okay. Any questions?
Just is any of them, like, are you guys considering? I know I've seen a few complaints about like the where they rollerblade and bike ride around the park or the trail at Heritage Park. Is there like any, you know, little stand lights or something like that?
I believe some of them will go there. I was very amazed when I was showing the music guy the building that we have nothing over there right now.
Yeah,
actually, this park, if you drive by it at night, is complete dark.
Well, somebody pointed out that pole, like when you're crossing, what would it be, Garrick Drive now or something off of Pardee, and there's a pole right in the middle of it, and it's not lit. So at night, you know, people ride their bike right into it. So.
Yeah, I'm sure Guido will look into that, his crew, but we'll be installing these internally. Guido's crew, otherwise it would have been Davis Bacon.
Okay.
So right. We're buying the lamps, and then they will anchor them.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman, there's about 20 of these that are going to go to various locations throughout Heritage Park, and they will be on it. Concrete footing. I mean, a lot of times when you think of solar, I think of the ones that, you know, $6 at Target that
right.
make about 10:30 p.m.
you push them in or whatever.
And these are pretty. They hold a charge for a pretty long period of time. So I think these will be very helpful at various locations. We actually had originally teed up a much higher amount. We dialed it back to roll out a pilot program just to make sure they deliver what we expect. We may bring a second phase to this at some point in the later in the summer.
Okay. Any other questions on this item? All right. Item 22, the motion to receive and file payment to eFax Corporation for temporary fax solution in the amount not to exceed $4,800, funded through general funds utilities account. Mr. Patel.
So, Chair and Council, on the eFax, if you remember last council meeting, we approved the permanent solution. On February, when our fax system went down, we had to emergency go with a temporary solution. was under $2,000 at that time, but cumulative monthly balance went over the council approval limit, so we just came for approval. And the current, the new solution that got approved last meeting, we just rolled out, we're transitioning in the next two weeks to the new system, which will significantly lower the cost.
Is there any questions from Mr. Patel on this item? Okay, item 23 is a motion to approve ESRI sole source for interactive GIS system upgrade for an amount not to exceed $36,000. Mr. Patel.
To council, to chair the council, again, same thing. The last meeting we approved maintenance for the GIS applications. This is the two more products that we're adding into that same portfolio. The reason for this product add-on, particularly, we would like to present to the citizens about our snowplow status and also the the street sweeping status of the, where they at, how long it would take, and the schedule online and also on the app. Since the most of the GIS navigation system is in place on those trucks, and then we're going to use that data through that system, put it on our GIS, and through that, you know, show it on the app and also on a website.
Councilman Johnson.